Module 1, Lesson 6, Expanded Form of Decimals. We're going to go back to our review of decimals, our expanded form with whole numbers. So when we had 45, we asked what place is the 4 in, and we said it's in the tens place. So in parentheses, we did the 4 times the 10 in the tens place. And then we had the 5 in the ones place, and we could just add 5. We had two in the thousands place. We did 2 times 1,000. Plus the 3 is in the hundreds place, so we do 3 times 100. And the 4 is in the tens place, so we did the 4 times 10. And then we just added the 5 at the end. That was how we did expanded form with whole numbers. Now we're going to talk about decimals. So first thing I'm going to ask is, how do we represent certain numbers as decimals or as a fraction? So if we have 1/10, 1/10 as a fraction is easy. This is a decimal. This is the tenths place. So 1/10 would be written like that. 1/100 as a fraction would be okay like this. And then we have our decimal. Hundredths is 2 places over. So we have 1 in the hundredths place. So we need to fill in a 0 in the tenths place. And then we have 1 over 1,000. And we have a decimal, and we have the tenths, hundredths, thousandths place. There's 1/1,000. 1 is in the thousandths place. And we have to fill in zeros for the other places. We're going to see that 1/10, whether it's a fraction or as a decimal, are the same thing, and we can use it either way. So we're going to start by doing expanded form now. And said to do it in 2 ways. We're going to do it with fractions and with decimals. So we're going to start that the 3 is in the tens place. So 3 times 10. And then we have a 2 in the ones place. 2 times 1. And then we have a 2 in the tenths place. So it's 2 times, and we just discussed that this represents 1/10. Another way to do this is 3 times 10 plus the 2 times 1. And we can say 2, and we can do the 1/10 as a fraction. Both methods are correct. Next, once again, we can do our 3, which is in the tens place, plus the 2 in the ones place, 2 times 1. And we have our 2 in the tenths place, and then we have our 4 in the hundredths place. When we write hundredths, this is how we learn to write hundredths, that 1 is in the hundredths place. So if we want to do it as fractions, we once again can go through. And this is now 1/10. And this is now 1/100. And last, we're going to go all the way out to the thousandths place. So we're going to do our start, which has been the same each time. Now we have a 2 in the tenths place, and a 4 in the hundredths place, and then a 2 in the thousandths place. And that's how we said we would write thousandths. So this part would all stay the same. But if we did fractions, this would be 1/10, this would be 1/100, and this would be 1,000. And that's how we go from standard form to expanded form. Sometimes, though, we're going to go from expanded form to standard form. In order to do that, the first thing I do is say, how far out am I going? I'm going to 10,000s. So I go ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, and I put my comma in. And then I look over here on this side, and I see that there is no decimal. Our smallest place value is whole numbers, so we can stay just as we are. How many 10,000s? There's 2. How many thousands? There are 4. How many hundreds? There are 3. How many tens? There are 1. And how many ones? There are 2. So simple enough. So we look at the next one. We go all the way up to 1,000. And the smallest spot over here is the ones place. So we do ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Put a comma in because it's thousands. How many thousands? There are 7. How many hundreds? There are 2. how many tens there are four, and how many ones there are eight. So next, we're going to look at, now this one's a little different. Our largest place value is ones, so here we have our ones. But then, we have all these decimal places. So we have to put a decimal in, and we see that we go all the way out to the thousandths place. So tenths, hundredths, thousandths, left to right. So how many ones? There are eight. How many tenths? There are nine. How many hundredths? There are seven. And how many thousandths? There are eight. So we're going to do one more. We're going to go all the way up to the thousands place. So we're going to go ones, tens, hundredths, thousands, put a comma in, because it's thousands. And then we look at the other end, and we go out to the tenths place. So we have to put a decimal in and go to the tenths place. So we have a two in thousands, two in the hundredths, seven in the tens, one in the ones, and a two in the tenths. And that's how we change